各位亲爱的朋友，大家好！欢迎大家持续的关心以太极门案件为例，来探讨宗教信仰自由以及普世的价值人权。节目一开始，我们先来认识太极门，它是气功武术修行团体，更是致力于发扬武德，止戈为善，师徒致力弘扬爱。和平与良心，行脚遍及全球101个国家，在美国社区深耕20余年，广受推崇。当然，在台湾民选的4位总统也都对太极门赞誉有加。就让我们来看看这段影片。
Qigong is not just mankind's most ancient sport. It transcends sport. From the level of the soul, it enhances the capabilities of the body and mind. Bequeath Taijin's splendid culture and achieve the overall health of body and soul.
The Mayor of the District of Columbia does hereby proclaim March 22nd, 2000 as Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy Day in Washington, D.C., and we welcome these international ambassadors of peace and goodwill.
So Mayor Harris welcomes Dr. Hong, and he declares September 16th, today, as Dr. Hong Day. We congratulate you.
Tom Bates, Mayor of the City of Berkeley, hereby proclaim August 5th, 2005 to be Federation of World Peace and Love Day in the City of Berkeley.
Ring the bell!
I wish for peace for all the people of the world, young and old, and for prosperity and a bright future for all.
For the past 35 years since its founding, your esteemed organization has upheld its objectives of loyalty, filial piety, love of the country, and love of society.
Tai Chi Men is like a big warm family. All Deizi are energetic and healthy physically and mentally. Under Zhang Menzhen's leadership, the Deizi not only practice self-cultivation, but also spread kindness to help the world.
Every time we see Tai Chi Men, we see energy, warmth, and love.
I hope that Tai Chi Men will continue to work with the government. Let us use our positive influence and move Taiwan forward with continued progress. Let the world see Taiwan.
Tai Chi Men Shifu and Deizi have self-funded trips to 101 nations and presented over 3,000 performances to foster a culture of peace. The Taiwanese government should redress injustices against Tai Chi Men and truly respect this precious cultural group, which has been a great cultural advocate for Taiwan.
优质的文化保存不易，世界各国鼓励于发扬传统文化以及保存文化资产也都不遗余力。太极门弘扬爱与和平的文化也受到世界各国高度的肯定。今天的语谈人 Cici 是一位建筑设计师，从他的分享，他要来提出对台湾政府良心的建言。
谢谢主持人。嗨，大家好，
我是一名建筑与室内设计师，也是两个孩子的母亲，同时我也是太极门弟子。我从13岁开始练气功，从小我就有着很严重的鼻子过敏和异位性皮肤炎，鼻塞、打喷嚏、湿疹严重影响我的生活，所以在妈妈的推荐下进入太极门，跟着我的师父洪道子博士学习气功与阴阳智慧。入门后几个月下来，之前所有的身体状况都有了极大的改善，但我从太极门，从我的师父那里学到最多最无价的宝藏是待人接物的方式以及对待自己的方式。我的师父教导我们，在高低起伏的生活中，我们要持续不断地找到平衡。磁场都是共享的，相互联系的，所以我们需要不断地向世界传播积极正面的影响，以平衡负面的力量。练气功恢复健康是第一步，很快的我们就意识到身体和心灵息息相关，心灵的健康甚至更为重要。师父教导我们阴阳哲学，赋予我们分辨是非与对错、善恶与真假的智慧，就像心中的良心指南针，随时随地在我们迷失时指引一条明路。师父带我们走访101国，传播爱与和平和良心。要有良心是一个人人都知道的道理，却很难做到，因为身为人总有太多的包袱，爱面子、贪婪、虚荣甚至懒惰都容易影响一个人做出违背良心的选择。在太极门里我学到，当我不知道该如何应付一个状况，最简单与最正确的方式是遵循自己的良心，不要因为担心对方的反应而有所隐瞒或欺骗。如果我做错事了，我当然会担心对方会生气，会责怪我。人们多倾向于寻找借口或推卸责任，但这绝不是正确的方式。也许我的隐瞒或欺骗让我因此而躲过被问责，但天知地知我知，我又该如何面对我的良心？所以直接承认并面对错误，然后承担责任，如此我的心就不会有罪恶感，我也就可以继续好好的生活。但太极门案件就是少数违法官员不愿意承认自己的错误，从一开始，从无良检察官侯宽仁违法起诉太极门的师父诈欺、养小鬼、逃漏税，以假证据、假证词，并隐瞒证据，勾结税务官员造假，欺骗国家政府，误导舆论，持续迫害太极门师徒长达近25年。说到底，这群违法官员就是拒绝承认他们的错误，从中获利，官官相护，泯灭良心。台湾自诩是一个拥有自由和人权的民主国家，然而政府为了自己的利益，允许流氓官员滥用国家公权力，带给人民痛苦和不幸。我们爱的国家居然伤害我们最深，而这样的情况居然发生在号称民主、自由、法治的国家，莫不是很讽刺？相对于美国的三权分立，台湾多设立的考试院与监察院，目的就是为了平衡与制约我们的政府，避免官员违法滥权的行为。然监察院也确实调查并认定侯宽仁检察官在侦办太极门案设有八大违法，却对其无可奈何。身为人民公仆的侯宽仁 非但没有被问责或惩处，反而政治生涯扶摇直上。试问，一个有权力的官员犯了错误，人们因此而受迫害，有人倾家荡产，有人妻离子散，有人背负着莫须有的罪名郁郁而终，而犯错的官员却不需要负任何责任，不认错，对待人民毫无怜悯之心，只为自己的前程与利益。在利益链之下，官官相护，这难道不是一个亡国的节奏？这样的台湾还有希望吗？人非圣贤，孰能无过？愿意面对错误，承担后果，令人钦佩。因为你要有度量与勇气承受批评。承认错误是第一步，是负责的态度，也是赎罪的方式。从错误中学习，然后成为更好的人。我们都会这样教育自己的孩子。然而，我们更需要我们的国家政府也是由这样诚实、有爱、勇于认错的人来掌管，这样台湾的未来才有希望。我诚挚的期盼这些违法官员能够站出来，承认错误，归还太极门的土地，平反太极门冤案，并对这近25年来所造成人民的痛苦和国家的损失负起责任。我支持政府有足够的勇气和智慧去做正确的事情，建立和实施一个公正公平的法治体系，作为全国上下遵循的准则。身为人民公仆的政府官员，更应依法行政，奖惩严明，公平公开，不浪费一分一毫国家公奴，废除奖金积习，税务官员依法课税，人民依法纳税，人人循规蹈矩，遵循良心。李运大同编中所描写的社会将不再只是理想，但这样的未来需要人人共同努力，我们相互勉励。谢谢大家。
在台湾民主发展的过程中，无端被卷入的太极门假案，最高法院早于2007年就已判决确定无罪无税，本该还给太极门人一个清净的修行环境，却让少数无良的官员无视公理与正义，演变至今，太极门的修行地遭到拍卖收归国有，这样的错误实在无法兼容于民主法治的台湾。接下来，我们透过这段国际媒体报道，期许台湾政府能早日良心觉醒。
Faith and political leaders met at the nation's capital on Tuesday, July 13th, for what organizers called the most important religious freedom event of the year. The three-day IRF summit advocates for religious freedom with a goal of tackling discrimination around the world. Former U.S. Ambassador for International Religious Freedom, Sam Brownback, helped launch the meeting with a focus on international bipartisanship.
This is an event sponsored by the International Religious Freedom Secretariat. All the major religions of the world are represented, and we've got one mantra, religious freedom for everybody, everywhere, all the time.
It was important for Brownback to tout the conference's diversity in both its attendees as well as within their organizing co-chairs. Dr. Katrina Lantos-Sweat is the former chair of the U.S. Commission on International Religious Freedom.
I was very honored to be asked to serve as co-chair because one of the things that we want to underscore throughout this summit is that international religious freedom is a cause that brings people together. I'm a Democrat. Sam Brownback is a Republican. Those differences are irrelevant when it comes to fighting for the fundamental rights of people around the world to live their lives in accordance with the dictates of their own conscience.
Many individuals and groups attended the summit to raise awareness for their freedom causes. One of the more prominent participants is the Action Alliance to Redress 1219, a coalition that seeks justice in the Taijiman Qigong Academy case. Taijiman Qigong Academy is a spiritual group in Taiwan and the U.S. They believe they are being religiously persecuted in democratic Taiwan through a tax evasion indictment 24 years ago that has reached Taiwan's Supreme Court.
The members of Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy are here at Washington, D.C. to raise international awareness of our case and call on the government officials of Taiwan to stop persecuting us and return the sacred land to Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy.
So we want to call out to government and other religious groups and spiritual groups that taxation should not be used as a tool to persecute religious groups, and that the freedom of religion and belief should be safeguarded.
In a July 13, 2007 ruling, the Taiwan Supreme Court found Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy not guilty of tax evasion and cleared the group of all charges. But Taiwan's Taxation Bureau disregarded the court decision and continued to impose taxes on Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy. Kenneth Jacobson, a professor of law at Philadelphia's Temple University, spoke at the summit and summarized his years of research on the Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy case.
Taiwan is an island of democracy, a beacon of democracy in an area that has absolute turmoil, political turmoil, as well as oppression. But what has happened here has emerged from the conduct of some rogue bureaucrats and government officials that has now been tolerated by the government itself.
During a 2010 public hearing in the Legislative Yuan, Taiwan's Ministry of Finance openly agreed to resolve the case within 2 months. That has still not occurred. As a result, Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy's sacred land was auctioned and nationalized on August 21, 2020. While Dr. Katrina Lantos-Sweat reserved opinion on the case, she acknowledged that an injustice has occurred.
There's growing concern among a range of legal experts and people who really understand the rule of law that this is a situation where an injustice has occurred that needs to be rectified and acknowledged.
It was important to the Action Alliance to affirm the persecution against Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy on U.S. soil, where Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy and its leader, Dr. Hong, have been welcomed openly in years past as international ambassadors of peace and goodwill.
The Mayor of the District of Columbia does hereby proclaim March 22, 2000 as Tai Chi Men Qigong Academy Day in Washington, D.C.
So Mayor Harris welcomes Dr. Hong, and he declares September 16th, today, as Dr. Hong Day. We congratulate you.
Tom Bates, Mayor of the City of Berkeley, hereby proclaim August 5th, 2005, to be Federation of World Peace and Love Day in the City of Berkeley.
Attendees heard many similar stories during the inaugural multi-day summit, where its main goal was to unite and help one another find solutions and prevent problems from reoccurring. Sam Brownback encouraged foreign policy and religious leaders to work together to solve foreign policy issues.
We just really got to get the civil society and religious leaders together to stand for each other. If we can get these relationships built across religions, I think we can really address a number of problems.
And this is Tai Chi Men wishing you love.
平反太极门假案更是台湾政府很容易就能再度获得国际赞扬的指标性事件。真理越辩越明，国内外专家学者多年的研究与发声都期待台湾政府能有积极作为，平反太极门假案。接下来一起来听听另一位在美国的太极门弟子 Wesley 的分享。
我叫 Wesley， 我是一名会计师。自从开始工作后，经常在会计事务所加班到半夜，加上常到外地出差，不正常的作息和压力渐渐让我有睡眠障碍，睡眠品质不佳，造成我无法集中精神，想睡又睡不着，常好像在晕车的感觉，那整天就像是在待机状态或是省电模式。然后我只好服用安眠药呢，强迫我关机。虽然说我吃的安眠药可以一夜好眠，可是呢，身体有休息，但是心跟头脑呢，还是一直在工作，没有休息。 我有精神后呢，就想做更多的事情，做更多事情之后呢，又想做更多更快，那就一直停不下来。我感觉呢，再这样下去呢，我一定会崩溃的。这时候呢，幸运的是，我的父母呢，跟我的兄弟跟姐姐呢，很早就在太极门练气功。那我一个弟弟呢，从事律师方面的工作，也是有压力紧张的问题。他早我一年加入太极门，看到他加入后的改变呢，第一次练功后就有非常大的改善，可以一两天的好眠，一直到现在呢，我已经不用再吃安眠药，也没有睡眠问题了。那更令我惊喜的是呢，我连续三年健康检查偏高的血糖跟血压呢，像今年呢，已经由原本是110跟135的血压呢，那今年都已经降到低压80，高压是115呢，正常。那身体的状况也明显都变好了。另一方面呢，练气功不仅是修身，更重要是修心养性。对我目前而言，修心帮我帮助很大。那学习克制自己，凝聚自己，发现自己有力量的信心。像我住得很远的，所以我到道馆要2个小时。开车的途中，心里是很轻松愉快的。我发现我变得不急躁，也不忧郁了，更容易感恩、惜福、快乐啊！这伟大的收获让我感谢师父以及太极门。虽然太极门是一个修身养性的好地方，然而呢，这25年来却遭受到台湾政府的人权的破坏。从太极门所遭遇的冤假税案可以看出，台湾税制有许多地方需要做一些建议，更改善的。例如说，台湾税务诉愿前应先缴税额的一半呢，那造成这个会造成很多中小企业或者是个人呢，家破人亡或经营困难呢。那相对的美国呢，只需要缴少额的钱，美元60元。那另外呢，另外一个就是关于行政诉讼的问题。那台湾的诉讼率胜率不到6%。主要就是因为法院缺少懂税的法官呢，例如说营业所得跟课税所得呢是不一样，但是法官没办法去精确掌握它的差异，导致就算是税务诉讼成功呢，但是法官通常他都会发回原单位去做去处理，那导致呢原单位国税局呢，那就会照原本的处理去做向纳税人去课税，那导致呢一些万年的税单永远都是没有改变的。那也希望政府能够早日平反太极门的冤假税案，那提升台湾是一个真正的民主人权的国家。谢谢。
谢谢 Wesley。 太极门师徒坚持1/4个世纪，用了25年来捍卫人权。全球太极门弟子的发声，以及所有海内外关心人权、宗教信仰自由的专家学者们，无不都在呼吁政府单位拿出魄力，承认错误，解决太极门案件。这些重要的谏言都是在帮助社会人心，普及人权教育、法治教育与良心教育。人的生命很有限，但是每一个我们都在为公理正义而奋斗，而这样的人生也更有价值。最后，借由《世界公民享人权》这首歌曲，让每个人都存一份良心，寄一份希望，来唤醒你我心中的良知，让我们一起持续为坚持做对的事情而努力。谢谢大家。